prawn cracker.
Mate, they eat noodles for breakfast. Why not prawn crackers? How your legs feel?
Fine, but I think I got bitten by a deadly spider.
Or a snake.
So basically, the whole of today, you're just going to be worrying that you're going to die from fatal snake bite.
Caffeinated and pastried up.
We've got 20 miles of downhill to start the day.
Sun's out, beautiful day, beautiful road, awesome.
It's very flat. Easier to digest.
Tastes the same.
It's probably your last chance at a croissant for the next 3 days.
Oh, don't say that.
How are you after the jungle experience?
Not bad. We made out alive, didn't we? We did exactly nothing yesterday, which was amazing. Now we're on the road again. There's a white man.
He's a white man with a moustache. Nice belly button.
Screw.
Guess what has happened?
James is fixing your puncher.
Yeah, Continental Ultra Sport. Fantastic tyre. Hard to get on.
It's been a fucking good tyre.
It has, hasn't it?
For like what you put it through, considering it's a, what is it, an 18 pound tyre at home? This is the tyre that comes on like 1,000 pound bikes.
A stock tyre.
And you've
only
had a handful of punctures on it. Wish I'd never been born at all. Shall we?
Quite nicely. This ride has just been so chill compared to the day before yesterday. I think we've fully experienced the Vietnamese jungle to the max. Now we should have a fairly straightforward run into Ho Chi Minh. Legs are feeling great after a rest day. Super, super hot today. Because we're losing a lot of elevation, it should mean the evenings are hotter as well. In the last few towns, as soon as the sun sets, it gets pretty chilly. But when we hit Ho Chi Minh, it should be lows of 25 overnight. Toasty.
Can you stop doing efforts? Because I have to follow you.
You don't have to follow me.
I have to follow you. I'm out of breath.
We're doing like 20k an hour all the way up here. It must have been at least 400 watts. Probably.
Do you reckon?
Yeah,
mate.
We're going at 400 watts.
Well, I feel a bit better in that case.
Is that cold?
Yeah.
So we just had a little sit down at that shop and checked out the elevation profile for the rest of today. There is actually quite a big climb coming up. Only one. Quite steep. We're gonna have to sit tight, tap it out in our easiest gear and hope for the best, I think. It's looking about 600-700 meters in one go, from what we can tell. On laden bikes, It is quite hard. Anyway, once that's over and done with, downhill all the way.
You got a paralysis tick on your forehead?
Viewers don't know about the paralysis tick thing.
We were in the jungle and I said, let's just check each other for ticks, because I can't remember whether there are paralysis ticks in Vietnam. And Francis' face was like, and all of a sudden, for the rest of the ride, he was just kind of...
Don't tell me any more facts like that.
Yeah.
I don't want to know. Why would I want to know that paralysis animals. Ticks exist? Especially when I'm in a fucking jungle. So I'm sure you guys will know an answer to this question. When the Vietnamese come and serve you coffee, they always bring tea as well.
Why is that?
Is that to wash away some of the bitter taste afterwards, or they always bring a little pot?
That is really good.
Yeah?
Yeah. It's slightly sweetened. It tastes like... obvious comment ever. It tastes like iced coffee. You know, I have a little sit in the hammock, 10 minutes.
With a big climb.
Put my feet up, big descent first.
You fucking asshole.
Time for a climb.
Yeah, love cycling, love climbing. This is New Jersey.
New Jersey, yeah.
Why is it nude?
It's skin colour.
It's not fucking skin colour. You look like a brute. If you don't like this music, then don't be listening to it, you know. I'm just a dude that you know, or something similar. If you don't keep it real, can you go somewhere but here? Cause you know we're only losing control. I say, if you don't like this music, you don't be listening to it, you know. I'm just a dude that you know, or something similar. If you don't keep...
It's not shit, is it? This is just unbelievable. So we've just descended.
The best descent ever.
It's probably the best descent I've ever done, and I don't say that lightly, because the view is just unbelievable. And we have literally got to the bottom of this valley, and someone has realised that he's dropped his phone. So I guess I'll be putting my feet up for a little bit. He's got to climb all the way up that fucking thing. Rather him than me, brother, I'll tell you that for free.
It is going to be dark when we get in.
Well, he's back, he's back. Oh, no, wait.
God's sake.
So the phone situation, more annoying than you think. Lawrence's laptop broke about 2 weeks ago, so it's actually his only device that he can use to contact home and stuff like that. Did a little bit of research and I took a photo of Lawrence halfway down this descent when we stopped to check out the view. His phone was on his handlebars then, so hopefully he hasn't gone past there looking for it. He probably has, because he's been gone a while now.
Someone's responded from my phone. I don't know how they've got in.
Oh, and they're trying to get in contact with you.
Sorry, brother, I went through your stuff and found your anarchy set.
Somehow, I've lost my phone, because I'm a... You can beat that bit out. And, basically, someone... I've just spent the last fucking, hour and a half looking for it. And someone's found it, because we've been able to message... He's messaged from his WhatsApp to my WhatsApp, and someone's picked it up, somehow got into my phone and replied, which is the weirdest thing in the world.
Was it unlocked, though, when you dropped it?
No. And even if it was, it would have locked itself. As soon as I noticed, which was about 3K of descent, so literally about 8 minutes, noticed, sprinted back up there and it was gone. Someone had picked it up.
Like, it must have been on the
it
road.
It must have been on the road.
Yeah.
So someone's picked it up, someone has it, but unfortunately they've gone where we came from this morning, not where we're going, which is... So we're trying to persuade them to basically come and drop it back, basically, for a few million dongs. It's just a load of stress that we just didn't need, and I feel really bad, so I apologise.
Don't feel bad, mate, it's fine. Yeah, it's fine, man.
Why don't you call Kai for me to miss Bang TM Vietnam?
What?
Why don't you call a cab for me?
At least we get a little night ride in. It's going to be beautiful.
Nice and cool.
Mate, I tell you what, if we can get to the top of this clock...
Nah.
Probably can't get to the top of this climb before sundown. Could be top. Be amazing.
That poor guy.
It's been a long while since the words came quick. My heart was there and my skin was thick. Blessed and cursed by the feeling.
You got a puncher. Rear. Anarchy.
Yeah, I haven't got one anymore, I lost it.
Yes. This is why I need two.
Oh, is that the old ceiling?
Found something?
No, it's just a fucking thick bit of ceiling.
Yeah.